What up, y'all, and welcome to Chicagoland Speedway for the 12th race in the 2022 FBRL Napa Truck Series season. Jordan Fisher is on pole for the second time this year with Tib Foster to his outside. Pair of Mercedes in row 2, Christian Vargas and Bobby Jones. Row 3, JD Martin and Dom Capps. Row 4, teammates Bob Burns and Edward Siemba. And in row 5, some more teammates Cody Goforth and Ricky Freeman Jr. 82 laps on tap for tonight's race. OnjAuto undefeated at this track in series history. The last two times we've been here, won by Jordan Fisher in 2020 and Ryan Butcher last year. Can they make it 3 years in a row? We're going to find out tonight. They are undefeated on tracks in this state. Butcher also getting a win last year at Springfield on the dirt track. Coming into this race, Fisher's points lead now 17 points over Malik Nevins, 21 over Edward Siemba, 39 over Alexander Rowe, and 64 back is Bobby Jones after missing the first two races of the season. There you saw Peter Onjak in the field, DJ Curtis, Mitchell Collins there in the double zero weather channel car. Half my face is still a little numb from a dental operation, but we're going to be making it in on the race on provisionals. Bradley Ream, Austin Rogers, Brandon Morris, and Sean Ard. Let's get you guys to trackside for the command to fire engines.
Gentlemen, start your engines!
Crank them up. Fired up. All right, bud. Fired up.
Fired up.
Crank it up.
Crank it up. Fired up.
We have a good time for this.
So 82 lap race here tonight, stage caution at the conclusion of lap 20. Tire wear here, as always, is about 3 to 4 seconds over a full run, the run being 32 to 34 laps. It's clear night here, 80 degrees with a southeast wind of 6 miles an hour. Zachary DeLello was fastest in practice with a 30.797. Following drivers that made the race are making their first Napa Truck Series start ever. Dom Capps in the 7, DJ Curtis in the 63, and Peter Onjak in the 69. All three one-off trucks making the field, 63, 69, and 00. Pace truck is off. Fisher, Foster will lead him to the green flag, and we are racing at Chicagoland. Vargas right away is going to go to the inside of Fisher, looking for the race lead on lap number 1. Outside line is very prominent here at this racetrack. It is going to be hard to pass on the inside line when everyone has the same set of tires. Once the tire strategies kick in and everything, it should get pretty racy. But right now, Vargas with the edge at the conclusion of the first lap, as they are three wide behind them for third place. Make that fourth place, as Foster is clear now, looking to the outside of Vargas behind Fisher, and it's a three wide mess in the pack behind them. Fisher will get the run off of turn 2, and he clears Vargas for the race lead. William Brock comes into this race 29th in driver's standings with 3 top 10s on his season, as he just slides up there in the turn 1 and 2 in front of JD Martin and Bobby Jones. Up to fifth place goes the driver of the number 1. Average finishing position of 26th. Average starting position of 15th. But Brock looks like he's got a fast Harley Davidson Ford F-150 here tonight. He is charging forward. Coyote Autosports alliance there with Texan Motorsports, which runs in the Sony Cup Series and Hardy's National Series, seems to pay off. As look at the move there by Brock in the turn 1. Looked like he was about to turn Bob Burns into the outside wall for a second, but tucks in right in line behind the 70, who slid up about half a lane going into turn 1. Is Malik Nevins, who started outside the top 10. He is charging forward as well. He's to the inside of Brock and Goforth, as everyone is still chasing Jordan Fisher. Looks like the Sony Cup Series drivers that made the field here tonight are not doing as great as they had expected to off the bat. Dom Capps has fallen outside of the top 10, but Peter Onjak has moved into the top 20. Meanwhile, DJ Curtis was stuck on the outside line 3 wide. He has fallen outside of the top 20, as Mitchell Collins in the double zero for OnjAuto He is struggling to move forward at all. There you can see the double zero behind the 89 on the outside line further back. But these are three truck teams fielding a fourth one-off entry. Team Velocity made it work with Jesse Turner at Kansas. So far struggles here for Curtis and Collins at Chicagoland. Battle is on for the race lead between Jordan Fisher and Tib Foster. There have been two off weeks went by. I don't know. Monster Energy Racing, though, they seem to have figured out something with their pace here. They are up front fighting for the lead, and they've got Breeding Enterprises chasing after them. But you see there, the inside line, Foster just not able to stick it to the inside of Jordan Fisher. Christian Vargas able to stay inside the top five, as is Bob Burns. For now, third and fourth, as Brock, Bobby Jones, and many others are fighting Cody Goforth to get into the top five. There you see Siemba with a big run. He'll make a move three wide down into turn three. Nevins goes way up the track. He'll check up, give up some positions here. Zachary Bilson currently inside the top 10, having a good run, as Austin Miller, Luis Hernandez, and more look to challenge from outside the top 10. Tib Foster going to make another run at it on Fisher for the lead, but unable to get it to stick. Back on lap four, Ricky Freeman Jr. was put four wide going into turn one, and then going into turn three, gets a little too high, gets in the marbles next to the wall, gets into the wall, and just grinds it around the corner. Falls all the way to the back of the pack from 23rd to 42nd place. Not what Ricky Freeman Jr. wanted to do at all. Well, one race ago, Eric DeMax drove the 05 for Shade Benyaka Racing to a win at Kansas after Jesse Turner Pitt coming to the white flag. Aiden Smith back in this truck tonight after suffering a level one concussion and a bruised wrist in his insane crash at Talladega. Started at the back, is trying to work his way forward, looking to pass Ace Wild, who it was announced is going racing in the Sony Cup Series next year for Team Velocity. Wild now getting shuffled to the outside there by the Zero, which is driven by Alex Benyaka this weekend. Zero has, I believe, one more attempt left on the calendar with Cody Lamas. That comes at Homestead. I believe that's the last one on the docket for the Zero team. I might be mistaken, but I'm pretty sure. But they are back here at the back, but you can see Aiden now moving forward. He's going by AJ Jones, Griffin Lapel McDermott, and Aiden Smith has moved his way up to 26th place. William Brock has made his way up the third. He's looking for a move on Tib Foster into turn one, but Foster pulls a block as everyone is still chasing Jordan Fisher. Foster, though, with a pretty good run here off of turn two, is going to go to the inside of Fisher into turn three. Can he get it to stick? This is going to let Brock, Siemba, and others close up as they are side by side behind them for fifth place. Brock giving all the draft to Tib Foster. He's looking to get by Fisher with him. Advantage Tib Foster to the race lead goes to 47. Here with four laps to go in the stage. Now you see Fisher get the grip back on the outside line. Help from his teammate Edward Siemba. Give him that draft down the back straightaway as he follows behind Tib Foster. Fisher will hold on to second place and look to challenge back for the race lead on the 47. And there is a move off of turn four. Three wide behind them there is Nevins, Bobby Jones, and Bob Burns. As we're here at the end of July, everybody, and man, oh man, silly season's gonna start kicking off this next week. We're gonna have so much to talk about at the Watkins Glen doubleheader event as Brock makes a move to the inside of Jordan Fisher. Can he get it to stick through turns three and four? Looks like Siemba's gonna follow the one like Brock followed Foster before. That's going to draft Brock up to second place. Now Siemba looking to challenge for third. Can Fisher fight back? And it looks like Fisher cannot. He is going to lose third place to Edward Siemba. So Fisher led the first 15, 16 laps of this race. And now he has fallen to fourth place. perhaps maybe a short run truck, or he just got drafted by on both occasions. Lack of draft here goes a long way, as now you see Fisher looking to challenge back for third as we hit the white flag in the stage. Everybody's chasing this guy, Tip Foster from Monster Energy Racing, looking to get his first stage win on the season. So far this year, we have had a total of 10 different stage winners, and Tib Foster will be stage winner number 11 as he gets it done here at Chicagoland. William Brock, Edward Siemba, Jordan Fisher, and Zachary Bilson. That is your top five. Vargas, Bobby Jones, Nevins, Burns, and Goforth, the top 10. Failed to mention, Jordan Fisher got his fourth career pole tonight. That ties him with Doug Lockrow and Luke Martin for third all-time in Napa Truck Series history. Getting ready to go back racing. We will have 59 laps to go here at Chicagoland. Edward Siemba is the new race leader. Brock in second, Bilson third, Fisher fourth, Bobby Jones fifth, Nevins, Burns, Goforth, Hernandez, and Austin Miller, the top 10. Vargas falls to 12th. DJ Curtis sits in 17th. Peter Onjak 16th. Tip Foster's pit crew really dropped the ball here. He is all the way down to 19th. We'll have to see if he can drive his way through the field. Fastest lap on that first run went to Cody Goforth, a 30.796. Fisher was fourth, Foster fifth, Brock seventh, and Fisher fourth. Siemba P3, I think I said Fisher twice there. Brock right to the inside of Siemba, looking for the race lead with help from Jordan Fisher and Malik Nevins. Nevins clears Bobby Jones for fifth. Right back to side-by-side racing here on the restart, and William Brock will clear Siemba off of turn four, and he'll be the leader here at Chicagoland. I don't think we've seen the one-truck lead since Atlanta. Similar style racetrack, but Atlanta with three grooves to choose from. Very Super Speedway-esque speedway over there. Chicagoland, the tire wear really likes to kick in and make it a one, maybe two groove type of racetrack. So now Fisher sees he's got his two main championship competitors right behind him. Siemba got a point on him there in the stage. Nevins, though, Fisher gained 4 points on, as Nevins goes hard into turn one, almost three wide with Fisher. As Brock continues to lead the way, it is a pack race behind them here down the back straightaway. Hernandez is going to stick it down there three wide into turn three, as Blake Warren has jumped into the top 10. Now you see Peter Onjak, DJ Curtis, Justin Johnson poking their noses there just outside, looking to find the way forward. But right now, everyone is chasing the one truck of William Brock. And Jordan Fisher is the first one there behind them. Nevins in third. Battle for fourth between Burns and Hernandez. And Mercedes, man, they have jumped into the top 10 all of a sudden. There you see Curtis now inside the top 10 behind Peter Onjak. Mercedes is here to play. They got their lone win back at Richmond with Blaze McKinney on strategy. They're looking to get one here tonight on raw pace. Fisher looking for the race lead on William Brock. Nevins, Bob Burns right behind them. Here comes Luis Hernandez in fifth place. Miller, Bobby Jones, sixth and seventh. Almost four wide there. Fisher with the edge through turn four. Brock keeping it tucked right to his quarter panel. We've got battles all over the top 10 right now. See Tip Foster trying to get back inside the top 10. Bobby Jones dives it underneath Austin Miller and Malik Nevins. Peter Onjak, man, what a show for him here at his home track, driving for Young Motorsports. local store there on the hood of that truck, Brown's Chicken. The cool color number there, green and yellow, number 69, as Jordan Fisher has taken the race lead back from William Brock, as now Luis Hernandez looking to take third. Look at Bobby Jones send it off into turn one. Hernandez will clear for third place. Burns looking to hold off. Oh, Bobby Jones kind of sent him off there into turn three. A little bit of an arrow nudge there, perhaps. That shuffles Burns back as Hernandez looking for second place now on Brock. Can't get it to the inside of the one. On Jack up to P4. It is a hornet's nest back here right now. Blaze McKinney has joined the picture. Blake Warren falling out of the top 10 in the past few laps. Tip Foster is back inside the top 10. That 47 truck, man, might just beat the truck at the field tonight. But can he get it up to the front of the field? Nevins will clear Bobby Jones here for fifth. As they race off into turn one. Bob Burns peeks to the inside of Bobby Jones, and I don't know if he got him arrow tight or what, but up the track he goes, and McKinney is going to get into him. Around goes Bobby Jones, McKinney in the wall, Curtis in the wall, Justin Johnson's involved, and it's a melee. Dagby into the 30. Big wreck down the back straightaway. Caution flag is out. Race leader is Jordan Fisher. And we just had big junk down the back straightaway here at Chicagoland. DJ Curtis, his night is over. That truck is destroyed. Austin Miller is going to bring it down. Zachary DeLello, Brandon Morris, Bradley Ream, Ryan Dagby, Justin Johnson. Oh, Griffin Lapo McDermott's luck continues. Ricky Freeman Jr. Looks like Zachary Bilson, Ace Wild, Austin Rogers, Kyle Springer, Cody Goforth, all with damage of some kind here. This is likely the biggest speedway crash we've seen since the season finale last year at Charlotte. Fisher will lead him down pit road. Let's take a look and see what brought up the caution. Well, we saw Bobby Jones kind of nudge Burns out of the way in turn three a few laps ago, and then Burns does the same thing to Bobby, and then just coming off of turn two, McKinney misjudges it, and he's just barely going to get into Bobby here. Down the track they go into Bilson. There's some more contact. That's what spins the 28 around. Now Bobby got spun around, and he was clean. No one hit him. McKinney goes up the track, hits the wall. Bilson trying to save it, goes up the track and hits Curtis into the wall. And then Justin Johnson has nowhere to go. Down into AJ Jones he goes. And now Dom Capps is going to get a piece of the 30. And it's on from here. Cody Goforth involved. Dagby's going to clip the 30. Then there you see Griffin Label McDermott hard into the 13. And DeLello slams into him. Look at Ricky Freeman Jr. driving it in there. Griffin Label McDermott goes upside down. Then you see Ace Wild into the 92. Look at Huck Davis is going to go all the way down the track to miss this along with Chase Dunbar. There's Ream getting the piece. Sean Ard, Roberto Crown Jr. were lucky they were at the back. This was quite the accident. And then McDermott lucky to land on all four tires, but a tough break for a ton of drivers. We'll go on board the KTM Mercedes of DJ Curtis and see what he saw from his vantage point here. So he's right behind this. And then he thinks he's good, and he's got trucks going left and right up and down the track. And then he's just going to get continuously hit here. Tough break for the Sony Cup Series driver. Not what him or Flipside Motorsports wanted to see tonight. We'll go on board with Bobby Jones and see. Yeah, I don't know if it just got him aero tight. Usually that gets you aero loose, or maybe he just went up the track to not get run over. He thought he was going to get run over there, was trying to just avoid an incident there. And instead, McKinney comes off turn two and just cleans him out, spins him around. But you see Bobby keeps it low, doesn't get hit by anybody, doesn't hit anyone. His truck is clean, just needs a new set of Goodyears. decent list of trucks out of the race. Justin Johnson, Zachary DeLello, DJ Curtis, Ricky Freeman Jr., Griffin Label McDermott, Austin Miller, and Ryan Dagby. Many continuing with damage. Jordan Fisher is the leader. Luis Hernandez second. William Brock third. Peter Onjak fourth. Nevins fifth. Siemba sixth. Blake Warren seventh. Alexander Rowe eighth. Bob Burns ninth. And Lane Sanders has entered the top 10. Benyaka is up to 11th. Lushon 12th. Tip Foster 13th. Dom Caps, Larry Hagan, Aiden Smith, Aria Carmona, Mitchell Collins, JD Martin, and Randy Riggs Jr. the top 20. Bobby Jones is in 23rd with a clean truck. Christian Vargas also was somewhat involved in that incident. He is 26th. Fisher leads him back to the green flag, and we are back on the way here at Chicagoland with a total of 44 laps to go. I can math. Hernandez, Onjak, and others with a quick move. Onjak to the inside of Hernandez, looking for second place after passing William Brock there right off the green. Now Nevins from fifth on the restart is going to make it three wide. Nevins has not won since California. They are scattered all up and down the racetrack here through one and two. Hernandez trying to get that outside line run going. But it's Peter Onjak looking to get Ford their third win of the year. And what is a one-off ride for Young Motorsports. Onjak happy to be able to race at his home track this weekend alongside his Sony Cup Series duties. And the team of Young Motorsports has just one win to their name in the Napa Truck Series. They got it with AJ Jones back in 2020. And they would love to get another one here tonight. Nevin side by side with Warren for third. As Brock down to fifth. Lane Sanders has made his way up to sixth. That's our New Zealand winner. And Lane would love to get another dub in the Napa Truck Series, but he's got some work to do here if he wants a shot at it. Tip Foster has climbed his way back into the top 10. Gonna be up to seventh here if he clears Hernandez, as Benyaka is looking to race his way into the top 10 as well. A couple of drivers have been parked. Those drivers are Bradley Ream and Brandon Morris. They were not up to speed. They will finish 34th and 35th, respectively. A couple of drivers with damage. Cody Goforth back here without a front end. He is just within minimum speed right now. Ace Wild, Kyle Springer, Austin Rogers, Zachary Bilson, all off pace. And then it looks like everyone else is good to go. As Bobby Jones, since the restart, he was 23rd. But he will get by Benyaka here and move his way up to 12th place. So Bobby Jones, man, making quick work at the field here as he just lost a ton of track position. Didn't get any damage, as mentioned. Didn't hit anything. Didn't hit anyone. Didn't get hit. How many ways can you say somebody got no damage? I just said them all, I think. Tip Foster to the inside of Sanders. That is for 6th place. Nevins looking for second. Warren looking for fourth. As everyone is still chasing Jordan Fisher. Just within the fuel window now here at 31 to go. Bobby Jones has made his way up to 8th place. Fastest lap on the race belongs to AJ Jones. A 35.43. Believe he got that in the previous run before he got the damage. No real changes up here at the front. It's still Jordan Fisher in the lead. Nevins second. Brock third. Foster fourth. And Siemba, the top five. Onjak, sixth. Sanders, seventh. Bobby Jones, eighth. Hagan, ninth. Battle for 10th between Blake Warren and Bob Burns. Yikes. Almost killed my keyboard. Luis Hernandez, 12th. Alexander Rowe, up to 13th. Aria Carmona, looking for 14th on Benyaka. 16th is Alexa Lushon. Blaze McKinney, with some damage, is 17th, getting by Randy Riggs Jr. Dom Caps 19th, Sean Ard 20th. J.D. Martin, 21st. Mitchell Collins, 22nd. A.J. Jones, 23rd. Christian Vargas, 24th. Aiden Smith, 25th. Huck Davis, Chase Dunbar, Roberto Crown Jr., down to 28th. Bilson, Austin Rogers, 29th and 30th. And then Kyle Springer, Ace Wild, and Cody Goforth, who is about to be caught by Jordan Fisher. And Goforth has managed to stay within minimum speed this entire run. Just trying to maybe hope for another wreck. Hope to improve his finishing position. But not the run Cody wanted here tonight. And now that they are in the fuel window, we could see something similar to Richmond, where drivers pit before they finish out their run. If they ran it out all the way, they wouldn't be pitting until about lap 72, 73. Or actually, under caution, they pit at lap 35, 36. So more like 68, 69 would be the end of the fuel run here, but we could see some drivers short pit it. Tire wear is heavy, but if you're going to short pit it, you're going to want a drafting partner. The trucks are so draft heavy at tracks like this that the overcut tends to work 9 times out of 10. Because if you have the fresh tires and you're in someone's wake, you will just gain so much time like nothing. Fisher and Evans have pulled out a little bit of a gap here over Brock as everyone works to get by Goforth. So this could be the main battle for the race, a Fisher and Evans rematch that we last saw back at Phoenix. Pit stops have begun as predicted, and the first one down is Lane Sanders from 7th place, about 2.5 seconds behind race leader Jordan Fisher. In fact, previous lap by Kyle Springer, Austin Rogers, Dom Capps, all coming down. There you see the damaged 88 of Zachary Bilson. Let's see what the call is here with 23 laps to go. Looks like it's going to be 4 tires and fuel for the driver up to 21. There goes Fisher. Malik Nevins is going to come by next lap down along with Tip Foster. Drivers on the lead lap still working their way by Goforth, Benyako, J.D. Martin, A.J. Jones, Huck Davis, Chase Dunbar, all into pit road. And you gotta wonder, how long is Fisher gonna be willing to stay out here? He's losing about 2.5-3 seconds a lap. Every lap he stays out, he'll stay out again here. Seeing a lot of the front runners stay out. Alexa Lushon will be the next one down pit road by herself. And look at how far back Lushon started. Her pit stall is all the way back here. She survived the chaos. She's currently inside the top 15. Now Fisher's got a damaged Kyle Springer closing the gap behind them. Still nobody pitting here from the leaders. Randy Riggs Jr. will come down next along with Vargas and the damaged Cody Goforth. There you see Lane Sanders. He is out front out of the drivers out of pit. There you see Nevins. Benyako is actually in front of Tip Foster, so a poor stop for the 47. Jordan Fisher has still yet to pit. And he continues to stay out. Siemba, though, second on back, is going to come to pit road. Carmona, Collins, Sean R., they stay out. So does Aiden Smith, Crown Jr., as Sanders catches them. Oh, and Sanders just got blocked by the 57, man. Watch this difference here in the turn one. Good night, goodbye. That is the power of fresh tires. And Fisher, after seeing everyone pit in his mirror, will bring it in the next lap. So about 3 laps before the window, before he would have run it out there. Everyone has taken 4 tires and fuel thus far. As you see, the other 4 drivers that stayed out, 5 drivers actually, that stayed out pitting with Bob Burns suffering on pit road. They're going to fall behind Alexander Rowe. Let's see what the strategy call here is for Jordan Fisher. Right side tires are up. Now the left sides are up. So everyone, four tire pit stop. Everyone thinking that tires will be the way to win this race. Fisher's going to come out of pit road here. Lane Sanders is already by him. There goes Nevins. There goes Benyako. That is second and third. Tip Foster, fourth. Lushon up the fifth. Jones, sixth. Randy Riggs Jr. is going to be looking like he's seventh if he gets by Fisher here. And he will do just that, but man, look at that. Siemba came down the lap before his teammate, and he just gained enough time to get to his bumper here. Tires really like to fall off later in the run on these trucks. So Siemba not gaining as much as he might have hoped for. But Lane Sanders has a near 8 second lead over the number four truck. Lane Sanders is out front here all by himself with 14 laps to go. No draft unless he can get up to Kyle Springer here, who he is catching due to tire difference and damage, no damage difference. Nevins is still second, Benyako third. Lushon under fire from Foster for fourth. AJ Jones is sixth. They got the lap truck of Ace Wild behind them. Fisher is giving chase. He is now 7 seconds back. Make that 6.3. He is hauling the mail with those fresh tires of his. Randy Riggs Jr. is 8th. Siemba 9th. Onjak 10th. Bobby Jones 11th. Hernandez 12th. Brock 13th. Warren 14th. JD Martin 15th. Puck Davis up a couple positions from the undercut. He is 16th. Dunbar 17th, Hagen 18th, Vargas 19th, McKinney 20th, and Bob Burns really did suffer on his stop. He is 21st, Rowe 22nd, Dom Caps 23rd, Sean R 24th, and then Roberto Crown Jr., Mitchell Collins, and Aiden Smith, who stayed out the longest there. They are back here racing for 26th place. Carmona as well. Carmona had an issue. She is 3 laps down. What happened to the 54? Well, back when they came out of pit road, Carmona had a flat tire right after getting new tires. You see Ard go by. This is actually why Collins, Crown, and Aiden Smith were held up so much. They were stuck behind the 54. They couldn't find a safe way by on the apron. You see them all stacked up there. Carmona fakes right for some reason. And yeah, but the 0057 and I literally can't even remember a truck number after seeing it. They all got held up though. 05, come on. But Carmona stopped it here on the apron in turn three. And no caution flew. With 7 laps to go, Sanders has draft off Kyle Springer, but Nevins, Benyako, they are there. And look at Jordan Fisher. He has flown through the field and cut the deficit down like nothing. Almost a second a lap every lap. Down to 2 seconds here. To the inside of Lushon, he will go. He will take fourth place. And Fisher looking to not be denied. Looking to keep the streak alive for OnjAuto in their home state of Illinois. And for some reason, I am struggling to remember simple geometry. This has not been the best commentary video, I'll say that much. Sanders, though, gets held up a bit by Kyle Springer. Nevins now right to his bumper. And look at Jordan Fisher. Just out of nowhere, man. He is on rails. Sanders blocks Nevins. That might seal the deal here. Look at Benyako trying to block Fisher. What is he thinking? How about Alexa Lushon, though? They're in fifth place. But, man, just watching the strategy play out. Tib Foster, what a fast truck he had. P6. William Brock, same thing. He's P10. Nevins will get by Sanders, but Fisher is already right there. Nevins throws the block with four laps to go. Sanders down to third. Edward Siemba also moving through the field. Right now, everyone is trying to work their way by Springer, who is a lap down. Fisher to the inside of Nevins. Down into turn three, they'll go. Fisher clears them like it was nothing. Pit stops mean so much, everybody. OnjAuto's pit crew has been on top of things this year. The pit stop for Jordan Fisher on that green flag run was a 14.7 for Siemba. Just as good, 14.8. Breeding's pit crews, man, they were about a second and a half off. And that could have been extra time they could have had here. But even with that extra time, I feel like Fisher probably drafts up to the 48 with about two to go, depending how the traffic plays out. But you can see here, leading the field, Fisher 2/10 faster than Malik Nevins. Fisher not the fastest truck, 30.757, but he was in the lead for most of the race. Fisher continues to pull away from Nevins. Sanders is trying to hold on to a podium. Siemba has kicked Lushon outside of the top five. William Brock is flying through the field as well. White flag is out. One lap to go for Jordan Fisher. Siemba to the inside of Sanders. He will take P3. Benyako going to get right to the quarter panel of Sanders. But up front, OnjAuto, what can you say about them here in Illinois? Here at Chicagoland, third year in a row. Second time, Jordan Fisher's going to get a dub here at Chicagoland. Fisher gets it done for the third time this season. And he ties Nevins for the most wins on the year, but he breaks the tie with Nevins on the all-time win chart. Fisher's fifth career win moves him solidly into third on the all-time win chart. And Nevins is going to have to do some chasing here once again. Nevins with a good result here tonight, though. Second place. Siemba third. Sanders fourth with that great undercut call. Barely holds on over Benyako. William Brock sixth. Lushon seventh. Randy Riggs Jr. eighth. Hernandez ninth. And Peter Onjak gets a tenth at his hometown track. Tip Foster, man, fell out of the top 10 there right at the end. Gets 11th. Bobby Jones, 12th man. Two trucks that were fast all night long. Had top 10 speed, but strategy was not on their plate tonight. And they end up with finishes outside the top 10 because of it. Fisher came in as the points leader. He just extended that points lead of his over everybody in the field. We are off next week, but weekend after that, it's a doubleheader weekend for the Napa Truck Series alongside a one-race event for the Sony Cup Series. Going to be a fun weekend there. We're running the Watkins Glen boot layout first, and then the inversion happens. Everybody that finishes on the lead lap in that race will get inverted to be the starting grid of the second race, which uses the 2.45-mile layout without the boot. And it should be fun. A lot of drivers doing sim work for this race weekend coming up. And yeah, man, I'm looking forward to it. But Jordan Fisher gets it done for OnjAuto here at Chicagoland. Once again, here come your official race results and top 10 in point standings. See y'all at the Glen. I'm gonna go get my